While everyone is impacted by the pandemic, not everyone is handling it the same way.
This is the first time that I experienced anxiety as this overwhelming problem. I stopped being able to eat. It was like this fire burning inside of me.
Masha turned to Wobot Health, a San Francisco-based online tool that helps people deal with anxiety and stress, developed by a Stanford-trained clinical research psychologist. It conducted a survey of 2,100 users globally. Nearly two-thirds of millennials and Gen Z respondents said they feel anxiety nearly every day. That's triple the rate of boomers. The reason could be tied to younger people having lost their jobs or not having a wide network of emotional support from friends or a relationship. It surprised researchers that only 1 in 5 essential workers acknowledged they were depressed or hopeless, compared to 27% of all respondents. Essential workers, of course, are often dealing with the sick and dying or related aspects of the coronavirus crisis. Allison Darcy is the founder of Wobot Health.
It just speaks to the importance of having meaning and purpose in the day-to-day work that you do, and how that can actually convey some protection against, you know, the worst effects of emotional distress.
The survey also revealed people dealing with stress and anxiety have identified some positive developments, labeled silver linings. A large number, ranging from 59 to 79%, said they created new possibilities, strengthened their connections with others, saw an increased appreciation of life, identified personal strengths, and created spiritual change.
I started noticing that I was trying to reach out to friends a lot, you know, texting people and so on. And I thought, hold on a second, I'm lonely and I need to do something about that.
That feeling of isolation, she believes, is due to her husband being an essential worker, a special needs teacher, who had to go to work and leave her alone. What's emerging from this survey is that each of us has different thresholds of stress, and that out of that can come positive change.
Often we don't know how strong we are until we're faced with the situation in which we have to exercise those strengths.
David Louie, ABC 7 News.